Hey friends, welcome back. It's Danielle. I have my April 2018 budget for you here on everydollar.com. I am still without internet at the house, so I'm just going to record this for you here rather than showing my Erin Condren Life Planner, but I do have everything in the planner, and I'm just going to show you the numbers that we have here on Every Dollar. So let's get started with income. Tyler's paydays, we expect him to earn $2,612. There is a possibility that he could get a quarterly bonus this month. We never like to count on that income since our income's so irregular, but as soon as we get it, it will go all toward my Huntington car loan. My payday, I expect to get $1,400. I'm paid hourly and commission as well, so this always changes. We update constantly throughout the month. I don't expect to get any YouTube income this month because I didn't really record a whole lot last month. And then rollover from last month, that is what we expect to start April 1st with in our checking account, $1,790.95. So that gives us usable money of $5,802 for the month. So of course that will change. I always like to estimate our income low and our expenses high. That way we can always have a better month than expected. So that's part of the reason. And another reason is we always like to do, we don't like to be short in our income. So we never like to have more month than money. So I've sort of changed my way of thinking when it comes to paying off our debt. We do want to be debt-free by the end of 2018. And so later on down toward the end of the budget, you will see the debt totals for our debt snowball. And so we have two left, my car loan and student loans. And so basically we're going to set a goal for payoff for debt for the month. If we do better, great, but we will not do worse. And so that's the main goal, is to hit that number. And then if we do better, that's great. All right, so for our monthly bills, Verizon is our cell phone. It's going to be $317.15. Natural gas, we still have this month and probably one more month for the apartment, $41.76. Spectrum, because we don't have internet right now, they have to cut down some trees, basically, is why we don't have internet. They can't run the cable, so we won't have anything due this month. Netflix will be $14.93. Duke electricity bill would be $107.62. Rent is $950. Dollar Shave Club, we won't have anything due this month. So thank you guys so much for using our referral link. I have a referral link down in the description box below if you want to check it out. It does not cost you a penny extra. And we should have a water bill for this new house. No idea what it's going to be, so I estimated it at 40. Variable expenses, we had a few extra cents and dollars, so I went ahead and put it on groceries for $629.49. Our ultimate goal is to spend less than $500 on groceries, and that includes some household supplies. This month, we will have to buy toilet paper again. We haven't bought toilet paper since January. So it will probably be a little bit more expensive of a month, but anything extra, it's going to go toward debt. So for restaurants, we have that pretty high at $500. Tyler's going to be traveling like 10 or 11 days this month. He's going to be gone. Definitely want to have that estimated really high. For gas, that's for my car as well as Tyler's car washes for his company car. We expect to spend $120 there. For personal and entertainment, we want to have a budget of $100. And I have the category here for rollover to next month, $1,696. That is what we expect to have in the checking account on April 30th, getting ready for May's expenses at the beginning of the month. Tyler should be getting a haircut this month for $20. So that is estimated in there. And so our variable expenses, 52% of our income. So hopefully we will get that quite a bit lower. With the rollover to next month, I should probably make it like its own category or something like that, because, you know, that's just money that we will have in our account for groceries and everything. Since we use our debit card mostly, I've really thought about doing cash. I got the cash clips from Connie Porter and I really want to use them because they're so darn cute, but I haven't made the leap to using cash again yet. So maybe we will this month. We'll see. All right, so moving on to debt. Down there at the bottom, you can see we have Huntington and Nelnet. Huntington is my car loan. We expect to put $1,246 to the car loan this month. And so the reason I switched over from paying Nailnet to paying Huntington is because I need to change my name to my married name on my title, as well as get the lien holder off of my title. So basically, I don't want to spend a single extra minute in that office than I have to, because it's always packed and you have to stand. You can't sit at this place. And so, as you can see there on the right-hand side, my current balance as of the first was $3,263.24 on the car. And so I just want to get that paid off before my car registration is due in either, I think, June or July. So I think I can pay it at the beginning of July and still be good and legal to drive. So if I can get all of those things done at once, that would just be so much better. I'm not sure if it would cost anything extra to do it separately, but one fell swoop will be nice. For Nailnet, that's my 3 student loans. I still have those. So we're not going to be putting anything toward those right now because I'm on an income-based repayment plan and technically there's nothing due. So our normal debt snowball has been $156 that, you know, will go toward Nailnet. That will go toward Huntington. So our current balance on Nailnet, $10,906.48. That's broken down into 3 loans, $15,6402, $43,8757, and $49,5489. So it's cool that there is like a little note section there where we can keep up with the balance on the first of every month, because I had been kind of struggling with my Erin Condren Life Planner, like where to put those numbers. So it's really cool. I can keep it here in the budget. All right, so for irregular bills, these are bills that are only due a few times or only once per year, but we want to keep them in the back of our mind since we don't currently have sinking funds. We don't have sinking funds because most of these things are under a few $100 and we can pay them with any given month's income. So we can go ahead and put more toward debt rather than saving up little by little. So the only thing we have due will be my retirement maintenance fee. It is $20 and I do use a Dave Ramsey ELP. After looking at last year's numbers and how well my Roth IRA did with them, I definitely want to keep their services. They're a great company, so I'm going to continue to pay $80 a year for their services because the profit they made me on the funds that they chose and the stress that they took out of my life with me having to not worry about it and just let them do the thing is definitely 100% worth it. So that is the budget. I'm really excited to get our income for the month. Excited to get some refunds. So Tyler's healthcare rental deposit from our old apartment, we expect to get that back. If you are on my Instagram, you already saw that we expect to get $300 back from the rental deposit, but they're sending a check in the mail. So who knows when it will come. So when that happens, we will just use that little add income button, make a new line item for that. And then we'll add the money in there. So if we get any refunds from any of those companies, we will do that. All right, guys, that is the budget. Let me know how you're doing for this month, and I will see you in the next one. Take care. Bye, guys.